Aha! Seems it's time to revisit the genre, Well, let's hope you're lucky once again.
Welcome back, folks. I'm AC, glad to have you join me today. As you all know, I made a video dedicated to Gmod ARGs a few months back, but with the way I presented it, I wasn't exactly betting on sticking around. It was just meant to cover the rest of the supposed channels in the genre, whether they were serious attempts or not. I'd say it's reasonable to assume that most of you are here for Gmod and source game related videos. Well, you're in luck. It appears that whilst I've been away, there's been quite a few more channels popping up around Gmod ARGs. Badwater Videos 2009, Plastic Apple 2011. Okay, that's only two. But surely there's more out there that haven't been covered by other folks. Oh yeah, the title. So, gmodcoolplayer1's channel was created on December 16th, 2020. There's literally no reason you need to know that, but now you do. The channel's doing fairly well, so let's check it out. No need for a fancy intro or anything. Of course, before we begin, you should check out gmodcoolplayer1 for yourself. I'm merely covering them for a video, meaning some things will be altered for copyright reasons and or left out entirely. With that said, let's start with their first video and see what they're all about. If you wish to skip ahead, the video thumbnail tells you how much to do so. Tutorial: how to make a flying car in Gmod. Nothing too off with this. Some glitching in the beginning, music issues in the middle, and some odd cuts at the end, but that's it. Nothing here immediately gives away the fact that something's off in-game. We can say something took control of the player's flying car at the end, but that takes a lot of guesswork. As such, next video. G-Man buys TV from Cleaner. Simple skit about G-Man buying a TV and returning it because it's defective. Kinda funny seeing as the player's game slash video is glitching out a ton, but manages to power through it. When G-Man's TV is shown on the island, we can still see Dr. Kleiner in the background. However, he seems to move on his own, as if he's alive. He flails around as if trying to escape, possibly stuck there because the player froze his lower half. G-Man Crazy Ride. Nothing really happens here, but I find it slightly disturbing with how the player keeps looking back towards G-Man. To me, it seems like they're checking to make sure he's still there. That G-Man doesn't somehow free himself and jump off the train. Gmod Scary Map Gameplay. Very good acting on behalf of the player here. Apart from that, no clue what the point of this video is. It could take inspiration from classic GM videos' graveyard part where he finds something at the end of it, but CoolPlayer1's video just ends abruptly. No figure. However, around 2 minutes in, we see two red dots before the footage cuts. Seeing as he wasn't holding the rocket launcher or grenades at the time, nothing in-game could have caused that. Perhaps something was watching him. Let's move on. How to make rocket in Gmod. Okay, there's a lot happening here. Starting off, we clearly see the ragdoll turn his head to face the player, as if wanting him to stop. After this, the footage cuts as the chat in the upper right corner goes haywire with errors. The ragdoll moves again and the player ignores it, turning back towards the rocket. In the background, we can see a thruster or something going crazy. The player then launches the rocket a couple times before the footage cuts once more. But after this cut, the video quality improves, as the errors in chat are now legible. Still no clue what it's about, though. Weird GM construct secret. Thank you. So CoolPlayer1 here does some weird ritual in GM Construct before no clipping through a corner in the map. His mic cuts in and out until he hits something that loads another map. The video freezes while it loads, and we hear him frantically shooting at something before the video ends. My one and only question here. How the heck did he find this? Yes, Gmod weird map. Again, not sure how to interpret this one. The player starts off in a map entirely made of building textures, and the maps from then on strangely increase in quality as he plays through them. The intro text implies he's just playing more horror maps he found, but as the video goes on, he adds text acting surprised as to what's happening. Perhaps it's to add emotional impact because he's not using a mic? But to me it feels like he's acting as if the map's jump scares are unusual, not meant to occur. Have you forgotten you're playing maps of the horror variety? Zombie Apocalypse Sys Part 1. The final frame is of the inside of a building, and I can't find anything else hidden in the image. But it could be where the camera is located with the creepy breathing before it. Other than this, it's a simple Gmod zombie apocalypse type video. Movie.wm. Never heard of that file extension before. Thank you. This is the first video to have a unique description to it. Previous ones are either empty or just share the video's title. We're given the year this was recorded, 2010, and a bunch of numbers. The first two sets can mean February 24th, but I don't know about the rest. Lastly, the reason for Half-Life 2 being here is because Gmod's executable file name is named Half-Life 2. Onto the video itself. CoolPlayer1's making a new Gmod skit with a surprising amount of detail. A pointless and dumb jump scare plays as the video briefly cuts to black. More cuts occur and some props appear to move by themselves. Something's messing with them. Scary GM Flatgrass Pit Secret. The thumbnail of this video is something you'd see on accounts for images of threatening auras. G-Man begs the player to leave him alone before getting thrown down the pit, and then CoolPlayer1 figures out a clever way to descend himself without noclip. I don't know what's at the bottom of this map, but I don't think that's where he landed. He teleports to some platforms before getting teleported again. This time it's a building which he falls to the floor of. He lands in a stereotypical insane asylum room with creepy breathing that repeats, somewhat tying back to the end of the Zombie Apocalypse Part 1. Panicking, he moves a burnt corpse while trying to escape, and a brief frame of G-Man cuts in. Perhaps this is the body of his remains after being thrown down the pit. The player continues his escape before seeing a figure in the hall. Feels very similar to the ending of Gmod Weird Map. Zombie Apocalypse Part 2. The video starts, and almost immediately, the citizen in the chair moves on his own. The next time we're shown the room from this angle, he's seemingly gotten up and running away. Lastly, it ends with the barrel being pulled towards the camera. G-Man Radio. This video is most likely G-Man's perspective from the bottom of the pit. Seems like him and the player wound up in different locations. Nothing really happens besides a sofa flipping over and movement at the end, possibly from G-Man. But if G-Man's here, in one piece, then what was with the brief frame of him over the dead body? The hunting of the sandwich.
Incoming! Sandwich! Along me! Oh no! Very bad! Come Sandwich and I are coming for you!
For a change of pace, we have a TF2 skit. At around 17 seconds, we're shown the scene from another Ragdoll's perspective. Assuming G-Man's still in the pit, this could be the citizen who wandered off Cool Player 1's zombie set. Movie 183. Cool Player 1 spots the citizen watching him and begins chasing him. The footage glitches out as we watch the citizen running away. This could help explain the abrupt ending of the previous video. The player was too distracted to finish the skit. Kleiner versus the bomb. Kleiner finds the bomb on Construct and tries to unarmor it. What will happen? Found on the video file description. Putting the section after Kleiner's scream through a spectrogram gives us a set of numbers. Initially, I thought it to be hexadecimal, but on a whim I decided to try decimal instead, and I actually got something. I can't say for sure whether this is right or not, but I deciphered it into they live. Regardless, this is true in context to the story here. The video ends with the player threatening to execute Kleiner, before throwing him across the room. Could he be doing this because the ragdoll spoke? Cool Easter egg in Sled Ultimate build.
Seventy-two, seventy-seven, eighty-five, eighty-three, eighty-four, eighty-five, eighty-six, eighty-seven, eighty-eight, seventy-two, seventy-three, seventy-eight, sixty-eight, seventy-two, seventy-three, seventy-eight, sixty-eight, seventy-two, seventy-three.
Cool Player 1 returns to the sled map to show a secret he found. While on the hill, he passes multiple skulls on his way down. He reaches the end and ignores the fact that his car disappeared after exiting it, and around the same time the music begins repeating itself before fading out. He picks up an invisible object that begins speaking numbers at him. Some parts are hard to hear, but the message is clear.
G-Man is alive.
The second message reads,
"You must find him."
Repeated twice. So someone's asking the player to help G-Man, when he is the dude who threw him in the pit? And if the player wasn't meant to find this Easter egg, then who's the message directed to? How to make Ragdoll Creator in Gmod. This is an odd one. Not only is this tutorial about something that's not possible in Gmod, but there's chapters on this video for some reason. The video progresses like any typical tutorial before Cool Player 1 says he needs to find a ragdoll that was missing. He then chucks a corpse into the machine before activating it. The thing goes haywire and the text "Help me" flashes on screen before the video comes back. If it's from G-Man, I have no clue how he got into Sony Vegas. Anyways, the player heads back to the new G-Man in the machine. Ominous music starts playing like he's an evil villain, and he immediately pulls a gun on G-Man. The use of Kleiner's lab objects to make this machine could imply Cool Player 1 may have interrogated Kleiner for how to make it? I don't know, sounds ridiculous, but just like the map secrets he found, he had to learn this somehow. Anyways, there's literally no point for him to say, "It is 2010 today." We already knew this takes place around then from movie.wm. My script writing is trash, but no one speaks like that. TF2 Sawmill Secret.
Point is now available for capture.
cool player 1 once again manages to find another creepy secret, the body on the floor possibly being the same citizen who ran from him. Overall, it's not entirely believable, but not bad. The next video's title is in Wingding's font, reading, "The key from the side that was behind all of..." Of what? The description is simply the word recording. The video starts from the perspective of a ragdoll, most likely Barney or a Metro Cop judging by the boots. He speaks in more Wingdings, which reads,
"I can't move, hide."
He either can't make up his mind or is telling us viewers to hide, because watching YouTube videos puts us in danger, of course. The player runs over to him before it cuts to another ragdoll looking at the previous one's unfortunate demise. We then transition to Cool Player 1 getting frustrated with a tutorial that's not going as expected, and at the end we're shown black and white footage of Kleiner. It is unclear who's behind the camera. A bunch of numbers. This might be a stretch, but I believe the description reads,
"A place where you must die."
Anyways, seems like we're being introduced to a new character. Up until now, Cool Player 1's only screwed with or killed ragdoll characters. This is the first one we've seen him deform. The head of this Barney slash Metrocop was essentially removed, either as punishment from disobeying the player or to just reform the ragdoll in his image. The story of this character continues in the next video. The Light Man, a new friend. Seems like Cool Player 1 is embracing a darker tone in his skits now. Description reads,
Light Man finds a friend during his depression.
Yeah, a depression you're directly responsible for. Nice job. We're shown that G-Man is still stuck in the pit, but a hand is missing and his head's been replaced by a light bulb. We're then shown how that blue sofa wound up down there, since Cool Player 1 accidentally drops it while making an elevator. Then, despite having decent skills with Gmod's mechanics, walks off the elevator like a smooth brain. However, he's not teleported this time, spotting the couch and the deformed Metrocop. Speaking of which, we cut to the thing holding a human skull before we're then shown the player setting up a scene with the ragdoll. He spots a light in the distance and starts running towards it, presumably the light man. As he approaches, he's suddenly tackled by the Metrocop. The player then wakes up only to see the Metrocop remove him with his tool gun. So, the Metrocop was deformed by Cool Player 1, and thus sought revenge against him. Somewhere along the line, he wound up in the pit and became friends with Lightman, and he saved him from the player. Neat. So if G-Man was still in the pit this entire time, what was the point of the ragdoll creator? Have there been two G-Men this whole time? Are these videos out of order? Good grief. Welcome to the deleted world. The description just says alone. So this is where Cool Player 1 wound up after getting removed. Cool concept, but I wish this title was less on the nose about it. Especially as we can deduce how this place functions from the flashback with him removing a citizen ragdoll. Anyways, he undeletes himself by jumping through a portal at the end of some parkour. So it's about as easy as clicking restore on something in the recycle bin. Sorry, but this could have been better. Beyond and back before having a head? I'm not playing here. The stories of a citizen feeling regret over sacrificing his family. A creature appears from those he killed to haunt him, and he then posts a self-deletion. If you want to watch it for yourself, feel free. Just be warned of what it contains. Hopefully it's just a cinematic and dark skit that has no relation to this channel's story. Going from one place to another.
Thank you. Message system web incoming messages.
Seems this video is a second name, as the description says,
"Hidden outside,"
and tape1.avi. Apart from that, we start off seeing a citizen tied up in the player's second zombie set. He manages to escape, but everyone else weren't so lucky. We then cut to the player escaping the deleted world and winding up in a dump. He gets out and enters a camp, possibly a refuge spot for those who escaped his wrath. However, it seems like the place was either abandoned or its inhabitants were killed. He passes an automatic message system which warns him to run. Something else has arrived, and seeing as he's not holding anything, looks like the Metro Cop stole all his weapons. We don't know who arrived at the camp, nor who showed back up near the apocalypse site, but seems like they're not on either side of what's been going on. Gmod, Strange White Room.
Very strange white room I found.
CoolPlayer1 attempts to return to his normal videos, but can't deny that something's obviously wrong with his game. His health bar has come back since the previous video, but he's wound up in another strange place. The video ends with him escaping the strange room and entering another portal. We're approaching the end of his story for now. Only two more videos. 500 subscribers Q&A announcement. This one has more information than you'd expect. The numbers below is channel statistics to go to.
I have the tool gun, you are no longer a threat to me.
We already knew the Metro Cop stole his items, but this message tells us that, for the most part, the Metro Cop isn't afraid of the player anymore. He holds the power, and he could be who showed up at the camp to pursue CoolPlayer1. We don't know for sure, but I get the feeling that because of what the Metro Cop's done, he's caused more harm than good, if not gone mad with power just as the player had. We don't know if he's responsible for the demise of the camp and its inhabitants. We do know that a citizen from the zombie apocalypse series survived, but overall there's still nothing but chaos. Nothing's changed since the Metro Cop of Lightman took control. Tape2.avi, the most recent video on the channel. More footage of the player's escape. We occasionally hear the sound of footsteps as he moves through the modified darkroom. He passes containers holding ragdolls, possibly ones from previous skits, as the first one we see contains the heavy. One of them opens to a pool of blood, and the text,
"I will find you,"
repeatedly flashes on screen. Metro Cop or not, whoever's after him clearly wants revenge for what's been done to him. Anyways, that's about it from gmodcoolplayer1 for now. Overall, this channel has a lot of flaws. Some worse than others, but there's at least an attempt at an overarching story here, and for what it's worth, that deserves some credit. Thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed. Feel free to subscribe, and if I find any other interesting channels, I'll definitely come back. And also, thank you so much for almost 1,000 subscribers. It's insane for me to comprehend that, and hopefully, I'll see you in my next video.